At 4:30, some retail shops are still reluctant to reopen in Cincinnati as the number of coronavirus cases rise within the city. Good to have you with us here at 4:30. I'm Craig McKee. WCPO 9 News reporter Courtney Francisco has been following store responses since the reopen. And now on day two, she tells us what to expect at major chains and the malls.
It's day two of retail shopping, and parking lots look a lot like this one here at Rookwood Pavilion. That's because not all stores chose to reopen fully to shoppers yet.
We spent a long time working through this.
It's up to each store to decide whether to reopen at Cincinnati malls.
We're sanitizing all common areas every hour on the hour. And so and we're encouraging people to wear masks, to remain socially distant.
The manager of Joseph Beth Booksellers in Rookwood Pavilion points out social distance markers, shelves where you will put items you touched for sanitization. Stores we visited did not have a shield between customers and cashiers.
I make fewer trips, but I go out and just, you know, cut the unnecessary stuff out, but I'm not afraid to go out.
In Rookwood Pavilion, many major retailers like Athleta and Gap remained closed on day two. Some, like Ulta, opened for curbside pickup. Inside Kenwood Town Center, not every customer wore a mask, but employees did. 48 stores opened here today, up from 38 yesterday.
I think that the situation has been hard on a lot of local businesses.
Ohio as a whole has had a decline in COVID-19 cases, so Governor Mike DeWine allowed retail shopping to start yesterday. But opening retail in Cincinnati goes against the White House recommendation of waiting until there is a downward trend of cases in a 14-day period. The city website shows new cases in Cincinnati going up and down this month.
And you want this one?
The atmosphere in open stores today seems confident but cautious.
We have a lot of procedures in place.
And remember, bring your mask with you if you head out today, because you'll need that at most places. And check outside each door before you enter. There's usually a sign that lists safety protocols. Reporting in Norwood, Courtney Francisco, WCPO 9 News.